Good afternoon. My name is Svetlana. She is Anastasia. We are creators of educational programs in Museum of Contemporary Art PERMM in Russia. We are really happy to participate in this conference. Thank you very much to the organizers. And now we will tell about our museum together.
And we will present two projects at once. It's an educational project for elderly people, Common Yard, and teens project, Conversation with the City. And this project are winners of ICOM Russia Awards in 2018 and in 2019. And first of all, we must say that 3 days ago, we have a really serious research of urban environment in Dubrovnik, and we found a deep connection between Dubrovnik and PERMM. PERMM is our city where we live. And this connection is Jon Snow. Why? Because, as you know, Jon Snow has been in Dubrovnik, and he's a very popular figure here. And Jon Snow has a PERMM hairstyle. And PERMM, it's the name of our city. And moreover, we want to show you two pictures, which we made 3 years ago in PERMM. And you can see snow, and snow, like Jon Snow, and winter is coming to PERMM.
But PERMM is not only hairstyle, it is also the city where the Scottish geologist Roderick Murchison opened a new geological period, the Permian period. PERMM is a city in the Ural with a population about 1 million people. PERMM was founded in the 18th century as a factory city, and it has a large industrial background. Today we have largest factories for the production of motors, aircraft engines, fiber optics, oil production, and woodworking enterprises.
Now our museum is located in the building of a former shopping center in a sleeping area, and we think it looks like a strange spaceship, and agree that space outside and inside the museum is quite different. And the history of Museum of Contemporary Art in provincial industrial city is rather unusual, and it greatly affects the presented project, and therefore we tell more about it. And we divide our history into three periods. And first period, it's a period of PERMM cultural revolution. And the museum PERMM was founded in 2009. It was the first museum of contemporary art in Russia outside Moscow and St. Petersburg. And the creation of the museum was a part of a new cultural policy, which is named PERMM Cultural Revolution. The initiators of this policy were a governor of PERMM region, Lev Churkunov, and the famous Russian gallerist, Murat Gelman. And the policy included the transformation of PERMM and its brand from industrial city to the cultural capital, and placing PERMM on cultural map of Russia and the world one too. And at the center, there was an idea that cultural life improves the quality of lives of citizens, and people would not want to leave PERMM in search of a better life. And we have a small little joke about PERMM cultural revolution at this slide.
Museum PERMM was a driver of cultural revolution and showed the audience samples of the world and Russian contemporary art, works by Nam June Paik, Marina Abramovich, Michal Rovner, and Jerry Hill, Russian artists like Ilya Kabakov, Alexander Brodsky, for example. Thanks to the revolution, inhabitants of the provincial city began to think about culture and themselves in the global context. People from different cities and countries began to come to PERMM. From the first exhibition, which named Russian Povera, the museum began to form its own unique collection of Russian poor art. Today we collect and keep objects made of non-artistic materials like unburned clay, foam, iron, coal, cardboard, plastic, and even soap.
And the first urban public art program in Russia, created by Nila Lakhverdieva, appeared in PERMM. It was a hallmark of cultural revolution. And the task of this program was to integrate contemporary art to the everyday life of citizens. And thanks to the public art, many people got acquainted with contemporary art for the first time. However, there was a valid discussion around the programs which reflected inhabitants' skepticism regarding cultural innovations and drawbacks of the revolution. You can see on the slide two sad examples, and in 2010, inhabitants of PERMM tried to blow up the rotunda by Alexander Brodsky, and in 2014 they set fire a Red People by a professor's group. And the main slogan of the revolution, skeptics will be put to shame, reflects modernizing, violent character of policy, it's been assigned by power, and the absence of the social projection for it. And the high level of resistance was based on the lack of regional agenda in the events. And this revolution didn't imply involvement of citizens in the design of urban processes. And the initiation of policy by the governor led to strong dependence on governmental resources and high politicization of the cultural life.
In 2012, second period started. In this year, the situation changed a lot. Oleg Cherkunov resigned as a governor. The political power's opinion about contemporary art changed. The project of the cultural capital was abandoned. Director of the museum, Murat German, was fired. In addition, in 2014, the museum was forced to move to a new rented building, our strange spaceship, due to the river station's accident state. For farewell to the river station, the exhibition transit area was created. Street artists painted work directly on the walls of the station. The key works where attention is growing up by artist Tima Ferradia, and they will erase me soon and you by Gandhi Group. This phrase reflected the common impression about the situation around the museum. It looked like the situation of deep crisis.
I will tell about third period of our history, and the museum team decided to reload their strategy to take into account the drawbacks of the revolution and to find new sources of support, the city and citizens. An educational program is very important part of this strategy because it makes a contact with audiences. And you can see some of our educational programs in this slide. And both projects, Common Yard for Elderly People and Conversation with the City for Teens, present a new strategy of communication with museum audiences. Today, museum use the ironic slogan, "Mom, I'm sorry, I will be an artist." You can see it on our t-shirts. Yes, it's mom and grandson, "I'm sorry, I will be an artist." What it means? It doesn't mean that elderly people, teens, children, adults strive to become professional artists, but it means that they can use means of contemporary art to release their needs and creativity to transform the city and to research an urban environment. And the technology for realization of both projects is the same. Participants, with the support of professional curators and artists, find some interesting locations in city, research urban environment, research the history around these places and context, and invent, discuss, and create their own public art projects in PERMM. And it's very important to distribute the roles correctly. In our project, participants, adolescents or elderly people became artists. Artists became tutors and experts, and volunteers and host institutions became partners, and museum team moderate this process. Why does museum team choose to work outside the museum in city locations? It's a point of the intersection of the interest of inhabitants of PERMM and the museum, and that's why public art led to the hottest discussion.
There is a stereotype that contemporary art is for young. The Common Yard project is proved that this is not true. Why are elderly people interested in doing street art projects? First of all, we want to show this picture. It is pig from a plastic canister and swans from tires. Such objects can be found to different cities of Russia. They are usually made by elderly people. Why do they do it? Elderly people show proactive position in life, many useful skills and Soviet background of street care that now are considered to be irrelevant. What is more, they very often turn to be taken away from social life after retirement, and gardening in the yards near their homes becomes their only way to apply vital forces and creativity. It's very useful for the city with depressive zones and boring industrial visual background. The museum team wants to support these interests. We are sure that elderly people will be more successful if they know about the means of contemporary art. As a result of Common Yard, 6 unique elderly people's public art projects appeared in Perm. One of them is project New Neighbors. There is one yard located near a central street. Therefore, all the building walls are covered with graffiti. The participants decided to cooperate with graffiti artists. In this project, 8 elderly women created stencils by themselves, up to full height. Each of them expresses their attitude to graffiti. Their works appeared in the yard. Some of women painted graffiti, some removed them, and some watched the process. Little joke, the PERMM street art group Fruit became the creators of this project, and 8 elderly women gave their team the name Dried Fruits. there was an unexpected result of the art project House of Memories, the solution of domestic problems. One of the participants had lived in a larger yard with several houses before, but almost all the houses were demolished, only one remained. The management company fenced the backyard from the residence and broke the boiler with hot water heating. The project participants wanted to solve this problem. An artist, Lyubov Shmykova, suggested to tell this touching story in the form of memories about this common yard, which would never be the same. The participants of the project wrote residents' memories on the walls of the house. The object was shown in several Russian TV shows. In result, the management company was forced to repair the heating. Following year, our work was continued. We realized big project, Remember the City. Elderly people created 16 objects based on their memory about city. Besides, today we have regular educational programs for elderly people about contemporary art.
I will tell about the second project, Conversation with the City. It was an art residence for teens, and over 8 days of working, teens created 5 large-scale art objects in PERMM. And why is it a conversation and who is talking? First of all, adult society and teenagers. In recent years, adolescents are increasingly becoming heroes of news in different contexts, like famous bloggers, civic activists, volunteers, and mass crime organizers. And news suggests that the modern age order is changing and teens conquer their subjectivity step by step. And adults should look carefully at adolescents. And the project creates a channel for a dialogue. And teenagers and adults. Often teens say that adults do not hear them. And creating art objects is an opportunity to show large-scale speech about important things in public spaces with support of professional curators and artists. And city and citizens and vice versa, the conversation in the city is heart-to-heart conversation. And teens try to return feelings and sensations to the streets occupied by advertising and political banners. And because the idea of communication, idea of conversation was important to us, we invited Timofey Rada, the artist, as a tutor, because he works with the text on the streets. And as a result of conversation, teens have created 5 large-scale objects. I will show 3 of them. One of them, it's object Water Between Us. It's a huge text near Kama River, and it's length about 60 meters. And you can see it from the other side of the river and when we fly in plane. And I think it's talking about emptiness existing between people, because it's a really important theme for adolescents. And the second project, it's on a schedule. The idea is very simple. Authors show their vision of modern society. And as you can see, teens believe then honesty, it's green line goes down. Consumption, it's yellow line goes up. And envy and cruelty stay the same. And self-esteem, it's my favorite line, red line, jumps up and down. And about third project, its name something in Japanese. And first, we found a wall near the museum and painted everything that we wanted. And then we decided to return this house into order and depict Japanese hieroglyphs. Why hieroglyphs? Because teenagers from this group were interested in Japanese culture, and because graffiti and Japanese are similar. And few people in PERM understand these languages. And teens' objects do not only cause a great resonance, but transform the city by the forces of its inhabitants. The format of teens' residence became very popular in PERM region, and today we organize more than 10 residences in different cities in Russia and in PERM region, with museums, camps, and schools, and during 2019, we made the residence with police and young criminals.
In conclusion, the project we described presents a new museum policy and a new approach to work with citizens. Today, the museum project raises not only global problems, but discuss local city agenda too. We still make high-quality projects with the best professional artists, but we also offer citizens a chance to become artists too. We involve audience in the process of creating museum content, meanings, and space, and we see the art as not only professional activity, but as a useful mean to change everyone's life for something better.
And we have two short videos from our audiences, and first video from elderly people, and they will tell about their opinion about contemporary art.
Время есть, хочется что-то новое, где-то есть возможность что-то новое узнать. Я туда.
Школа, институт, завод. Пенсия, вышла на пенсию, как говорится, занялась танцами, хип-хопом. Сейчас веду богемный образ жизни.
И вот, решив немного сказать, поразвлечься и расширить свой кругозор, и услышав по телевизору о таком проекте, я здесь.
И оказывается, оно интересное. Сначала я думала, ну, это, ну да, интересно, но это не искусство. А сейчас я все больше склоняюсь, что это, однако, наверное, искусство.
Не то слово, узнала много нового. Я сейчас уже никогда не пройду мимо объекта, который мне не нравится. Я постараюсь его понять, я постараюсь понять идею художника и, может быть, даже полюбить. Мимо не пройду никогда уже теперь.
Как и создание произведения искусства, так и восприятие субъективно. Поэтому что-то нравится, что-то не воспринимаешь.
Мы не должны спрашивать, что хотел изобразить художник, что ты чувствуешь, смотря на эту картину.
Этот проект он заставил залезть в интернет, поподробнее узнать про авторов. И, то есть, дает позыв к познанию чего-то нового и подробнее узнать про это.
Я прихожу, когда домой, я сажу своих детей, внуков, и я им рассказываю все лекции, которые здесь слушал.
Мой личный совет – ходить на выставки, попробовать придумать что-нибудь самому. Всегда легко критиковать.
Приходить в музей и смотреть.
Смелый человек. Человек смелый может стать художником в современном мире.
Что никогда не надо останавливаться. Следующий. Никогда университет не заканчивается. Он продолжается и продолжается по жизни. Только тогда ты и живешь, когда ты интересуешься, осваиваешь следующий университет, следующую там школу.
And the second video by the museum teams, and they created this video especially from this conference.
Hello, my name is Alyssa. I'm 18 years old.
Hi, my name is Aisha.
And PERMM Museum of Contemporary Art completely changed my life.
Museum of Modern Art is the best for all.
Participating in museum's project helped me to understand myself, to understand the world, to find friends, and to feel togetherness with the wonderful museum's team.
And these projects for teenagers is the best time for me and our pupils.
PERMM isn't like paradise, but I think I started to understand and feel that city more, and I loved PERMM since that project more.
It's hope, it's motivation, and it's inspiration. It's a great part of inner confidence for every teenager that took part in it. It's work with the real artist, and it's you being a real artist. We can be whoever we want.
Art, especially modern art, gives you an opportunity to think about your life, to think about what you're actually feeling and what you want.
And I really want to work in the museum in future because I see museums as perfect places for education, unlike schools in Russia.
In 11th grade, a lot of teachers told me that I will never earn enough money, that I will never go to a good university. And then I always thought about this project, and that at 16 I and my friends made a street artwork, and this thought was really calming. So I just really grateful that it happens to me, to meet all these people, to just to have an opportunity to say something about my city, in my city.
In our conversation with the city, we were accepted and understood by PERMM.
That's all.